I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my...
Okay, so the lighting is kind of trashy in here, but your girl is going home. Back to the States, yes. So, just packing up, as you can see. Packing up all my stuff. And I gotta wash clothes. So yeah, so I'm just packing up. But yeah, like, I'm so excited to go home. I've been gone for 9 months over here, overseas or whatever. So to finally be going home is such a great feeling. But so I have to fit all of my stuff in this bag. All of this. And then it's already in, got a fitness bag, so. So now what I'm doing, I'm just at the USO right now.
Oh yeah, stripes. Yeah,
they're playing pool. I'm just sitting here playing pool. Just waiting to go.
I have to get off the table first. It's a war zone. It's a war zone. It's a war zone out here. They're flocking.
No, but like low key, I'm like really ready to go. Please don't come and mess my vlog up. What's that? Oh my gosh. But yeah, we have a few hours until we leave, so like I said, everybody's just doing stuff to pass time by. So, as you can see, like, I'm really tired. Like, it's like about to be like 1 o'clock in the morning and I'm still up. I'm super tired, so that's it.
What's the
throwback? What, I need him.
Yeah.
Look at my eyes.
Hey,
hey,
mom.
If he miss it, though, that'd be crazy,
man. Shut up. Hey, weed. This carpet is so big on loose.
Oh. So currently it's like 2 a.m. Oh. And, oh, sorry. So currently it's like 2 a.m. and we are moving out of our rooms. About to take our bags up to the front, so yeah. Alright, so I'm done packing my room. Well, taking everything empty. So this is the last time I will be living in transit barracks. We out. I look so tired, y'all. It's from my... Okay, guys, so just a quick update. It is now... Excuse me. I'm so sorry. It is now 2:28, and right now we are at the airline, and I volunteered for weapons watch because I was not trying to go load no bags. I ain't even gonna lie, but yeah, it's 2:28, and we're at the airline right now, and we're loading the bags onto the plane, and I should have recorded. I don't know why I didn't. Because I was sleeping. But I was sleeping, but I was gonna record the bus ride over here because it was pretty nice. But like I said, I was in and out of sleep, so like I have not been asleep in like 24 hours. So, but yeah. All right, so I'm just gonna give y'all a brief description of my deployment since obviously, like I said, they put me on weapons watch and I don't have nothing else to do. So I'm just gonna go ahead and talk to y'all. So I left back in May, and it's now February, so like I said, I've did 9 months here over in the Middle East, and it's been pretty chill. I can't really, you know, I'm not gonna complain about my deployment, because you know, it was a good first deployment for me. You know, others may have different opinions, but yeah, like I said, my deployment was pretty chill. So yeah, like I said, you know, just been over here, finally going home. Like, I'm so excited. Like, I know I keep saying this, but y'all just don't understand. Like, 9 months away from like your freedom, like, is everything. Like, I promise, it's like it's everything. So like, I'm super excited to like to go back into the States, like get back in the groove of things, like to go see my family, my friends, like to go eat like real fast food. Like, whenever I want to go, just get my car and just go eat, go shopping. Like, I don't have to shop online anymore. So yeah, you know, it's really a good feeling. You know, once you finish 9 months of a deployment, you know, you feel like you accomplished something. You know, I felt like I brought a few things back from this deployment than when I left. I feel like my leadership skills are better. I came back as a specialist. I came here as a PFC, so I'm leaving as a specialist. So I've taken like a ton of classes out here, stuff to get me promoted and all that stuff like that. So, you know, I really worked hard while I was out here. Like I say, you know, came back better than I was. So yeah. So some of the challenges that I faced out here was, I think my biggest challenge is being away from my family, because I've never been away from my family like for this long without seeing them. Like, even when I moved to North Carolina, like, I was still like go home like every like weekend for 4 days or whatever. So like, I've never been away from them for 9 months. So like, talking to them on FaceTime, like, it's just like, it wasn't enough, you know. Yeah, it's like, it's really hard, especially like if you're a big family person like me, it's really hard. I feel like the thing that I'm like most like excited about, like food wise going back, is I think I'm really excited about going back to like Kickback Jack's. Like, let me tell y'all, let me put y'all onto something real quick. If y'all have never been to Kickback Jack's, you're wrong. Like, you are so wrong. If you've never been to Kickback Jack's, you are so wrong. Like, let me tell you, Kickback Jack's has like the best wings. Like, to me, they have like the best wings. Like, better than Buffalo Wild Wings. Like, I feel like Kickback Jack's has the best wings. Like, that's the only thing I eat there. Is their wings. I think it's like sweet Thai chili wings. Those like are so good. Like, I'm trying to tell y'all, like, y'all try it and y'all gonna be like, oh snap, Adeja put me onto something. Because I did put you onto something. It's like, I'm so forward to getting my hair done, y'all. Let me tell y'all, I put this dye in my hair the other day thinking it was gonna pop, and it did not. It was a fail. It was a complete fail. I mean, it's starting to fade away. Like, don't mind my fuzziness either. I'm trying to tell you, I am really like looking like a bum in the uniform. Seriously. So I'm looking forward to like trying new stuff for my face, because as you can see, my face has like been breaking out really bad out here. I got like dark marks and all that stuff like that. I'm so excited to get my eyebrows done, and I'm so excited to get cute, because all these clothes that I bought while I was like over here, like, I'm about to dress it up, okay? Because your girl is really about to look good. Like, I'm definitely gonna make sure y'all see that. So one thing that really kills me is that when people like, they sleep like for like hours on the plane, like six, like, maybe that's too much, but maybe like a 3-4 hours, and they be getting up and want to talk in your face. Like, no, you gotta brush your teeth. I'm really tripping. Mouthwash, travel size mouthwash, is that if you do not bring your toothbrush, okay, if you don't bring your toothbrush at all, toothbrush, toothpaste, whatever, mouthwash is essential. Like, I'm not trying to be smelling your breath, especially when you wake up. I'm definitely not trying to have you smell mine. And last but not least, some deodorant, you know, you gotta have deodorant too. So yeah, that's just my traveling, you know, it's case, but that's just my traveling, like, you know, essentials or whatever, my traveling essentials that I, you know, carry with me. Because, you know, going back, you know, people family gonna be there, you know, and can't be looking at me crazy, you know. my people ain't seen me in, Lord knows, like 9 months. So, can't be looking crazy for the folks. Can't be looking crazy for the folks. So, guys, we made it on the plane. Yes, I'm so excited because it's legit real now. So, but yeah, so, I mean, it's pretty lit. I mean, got the TVs going on or whatever. But yeah, so, you know, everybody just getting settled, all that good stuff. So, yep. I'm really feeling these like blankets, and they provide us with like a pillow. So I think that's really cool. So it is now 12:34. I don't know if this is the accurate time for Ireland or not, but on my phone that's what it says 12:34, and we're in Ireland, and we have a 2-hour layover, so we're just, you know, chilling here or whatever until, I guess, until our flight, you know, is ready and all that stuff for us to go next. I am tired. I like literally slept, like I popped a sleeping pill and I like slept the entire time on the plane, like for 7 hours. I mean, I woke up here and there because it was hella cold on there. I'm not even gonna lie to you, it was like super cold. But really nice airport though. I've never been to like a legit airport because I never rode on a plane until I first deployed. So it's a really nice airport, I'm not even gonna lie to you. So
as you can see, I have moved to like a different part than my whole company because they were really pissing me off. I'm not even gonna lie, like they were really pissing me off. So I got this whole like little section to myself. Hopefully they don't leave me, but.
I'm so childish. I always want to hit the back of people's
legs. I'm dying. If you do that, then she'll think it's me.
But
I'm back home. See me stop. So, we're definitely back. And, wow. Never been more excited about anything in my life.
Nothing?
Huh?
Nothing?
No, I've never been more excited about anything in my life until now.
I didn't believe it until we were up in the air.
Yeah. Exactly, it didn't feel real.
What is this?
Is my weapon up here? This is your PC.
Yeah. Just gotta grab my lip.
You said what? I'm grabbing it. Got my baby back.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to be the first to welcome you back to the United States of America.
Woo!
Welcome to Pope Air Force Base, where the local time is approximately. I'm coming home, tell the world that I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. And all my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven my mistakes.
Thank you.
No stopping us now, I love that song. Whenever it comes on, it makes me feel strong. I thought I told you that we won't stop till we back cruising through Harlem. These old blocks is what made me, saved me, drove me crazy, drove me away, then embraced me, forgave me for all of my shortcomings. Welcome to my homecoming. Yeah, it's been a long time coming. A lot of fights, a lot of scars, a lot of bottles, a lot of cars, a lot of ups, a lot of downs. Made it back, lost my dog.
Miss you,
but here I stand. Come on, a better man.
Don't stop.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Lord. I'm coming home. Oh. Tell the world that I'm coming home.
I'm coming home.
Guys,
I just want to tell y'all how lit I am right now because I am back in the States, y'all. The only bad thing about this is my room. Like, you know, I love my roommate. I love my roommate to death. You know, my best friend forever. But this room is a no-go. Like, let me show y'all real quick. But my ring light in here. My lights got to go in here. Like, we got to figure out how we going to work a curtain in the middle of this. Like, I'm really about to go to Walmart, and we about to get some cleaning supplies. We about to disinfect this whole place, you know, because, you know, it's kind of disgusting here. I'm not going to lie. But, and let me give y'all a little room tour real quick.
Hold that part.
And, yeah. So, anyways, you walk in the room. And it's like two closets right here. One right here. I probably end up making this one my closet. I don't know. Let me see. You know, like a little, it's like, look like a little pantry or whatever, I guess. And so we gotta clean that out. But yeah, so it's a closet. And then it's like a little mini kitchen right here, like two little stove tops and a cabinet. This is definitely gonna come in handy. Sink. But like I said, we gotta clean all of this out. More cabinets, a microwave, and stove, refrigerator. Okay, so this bathroom, granted, like really gotta get cleaned out. Like, I don't know what the heck that is, but we want to clean that out. I look rough, y'all. Don't mind me. Seriously, gotta clean that mirror. The toilet, I don't even want to touch the toilet until I get gloves and clean that. And so this is my side of the room. Like I said, so this is literally just how it looks. Like, as you can see, it's like, as you can see, like, it's like no wall right here, so we literally can see each other, wake up and like see her face. But that's the bed. Then we have like this little side, got a little desk, I guess you want to call it. And then walk in here, like I said, not touching nothing really until I get gloves. So yeah, that's basically my new room. I guess they say it's temporary, but who knows how freaking temporary it is. So, oh my goodness. First of all, so I'm in Walmart, and I think I went a little bit overboard for, you know, the first day back, but whatever. I'm just here buying, like, cleaning stuff so, you know, I can clean. So I can clean the room. So I don't be knowing what stuff to get. Like, I just need some regular little gloves. I don't know. I'm just so like overwhelmed. Alright, so obviously, you know, the comeback, I had to get McDonald's, and I'm gonna put y'all into something. The number 11 for breakfast. The bacon, egg, and cheese bagel is on point. So yeah, I can't wait to eat this. And look at all this stuff that I bought. I really think I went overboard.
A lot of fights, a lot of scars, a lot of bottles, a lot of cars, a lot of ups, a lot of downs. Made it back, lost my dog.
Miss you,
but here I stand, a better man.